In this video, we'll discuss a topic of chemical fuels, calorific value, higher calorific value, lower calorific value, and calculation of theoretical calculation of calorific value using Dulong's formula. So what is calorific value? So before knowing this calorific value, let us define chemical fuel. Chemical fuel is a combustible substance which produces huge amount of heat, and it is useful economically as for domestic purpose or industrial purpose on burning in presence of air or oxygen. So any substance which produces economically useful heat in presence of air or oxygen, we can call as a chemical fuel. Now the heat content or the quantity or amount of heat content is expressed using this calorific value. Now we can define this calorific value as the amount of heat released when a unit mass or volume of a fuel is burnt completely in air or oxygen. It is the amount of heat released when a unit mass or unit volume of a fuel is burnt completely in air or oxygen. Here, in this definition, we have a unit mass or a unit volume. In the sense, we may have solid fuels, liquid fuels, gaseous fuels. So, based on that solid fuels, we calculate the mass, whereas for gaseous or liquid fuels, we calculate the volume. Now, this calorific value units we have, that is calorie. So, calorie is the amount of heat required to rise the temperature of 1 gram of water through 1 degree centigrade, and kilocalorie is equal to 1000 calories. So, just calorie we convert into kilocalorie. So, we can define as the quantity of heat required to rise the temperature of 1 kilogram of water through 1 degree centigrade. Then, thus we can write 1 kilocalorie is equal to 1000 calories. And one more English system unit is there, that is British thermal unit. We can define as the heat is the quantity of heat required to rise the temperature of 1 pound of water through 1 degree Fahrenheit. That is called BTU, British Thermal Unit. So, this is a calorific value definition and units. Now, we will go for the two more types of definitions for calorific value. That is higher calorific value and lower calorific values. So, higher calorific value, also call as gross calorific value. So, we abbreviate HCV or GCV. So, here we can define it as the amount of heat released when unit quantity of a fuel is burnt completely in air and the combustion products are cooled to room temperature. So, generally the combustion products are the flue gases and the moisture. Moisture is formed due to hydrogen present in the fuel. That hydrogen is converted into water vapors, and this water is vaporized by absorbing some amount of heat, which we call as latent heat of steam. So, in this higher calorific value, this high calorific value includes that latent heat of steam also. So, total heat, the gross heat is calculated in this definition. So, it is called as higher calorific value or gross calorific value. It is defined as the amount of heat released when unit quantity of fuel is burnt completely in air and the combustion products are cooled to room temperature. Here it includes the latent heat of steam. Next, lower calorific value LCV, or we can call net calorific value NCV. Same definition, but here we let off that combustion products into the atmosphere. So, this is the definition. It is defined as the amount of heat released when a unit mass or unit volume unit quantity I am writing here. So unit mass or unit volume of a fuel is burned completely in air, and the products of combustion are let off into the atmosphere. Means we are allowing to escape latent heat of steam from the total heat, that gross heat. We are allowing to let off the latent heat of steam. So from the total heat value, we have to subtract that latent heat of steam. So we can write LCV is equal to HCV minus latent heat of steam. And further, we can write the latent heat of steam is 587 calories per gram or 587 kilocalories per kg. Now, since one part of hydrogen by mass, is producing the 9 parts of water, here we are writing HCV minus 9 into percentage of hydrogen by 100 into 587 calories per gram. So here 9 means the amount of heat produced. So 9 parts of water is produced for 1 part of the hydrogen. So that is the reason we are writing multiplying the hydrogen percentage with 9 divided by 100. Now come to the theoretical calculation of the calorific value. So this theoretical calculation can be done by using Dulong's formula. See, the HCV of a fuel we can call total fuel. We are defining it as a total fuel. So this heat is produced by the all the constituents of the fuel burnt. So we can define the HCV of a fuel is the sum of calorific values of all the constituents present in the fuel. For your information, here the hydrogen produces about 34,500 kilocalories per kg, whereas carbon produces 8,080 kilocalories per kg, and sulfur produces a calorific value, higher calorific value of 2,240. Using these values, we can write Dulong's formula as HCV is equal to 1 by 100 into 8,080 C plus 34,500 into H minus O by 8 plus 2,240 sulfur kilocalories per kg. So this carbon C, carbon and H hydrogen, O oxygen, S sulfur indicates the percentages of their percentage present in the fuel. Here we are subtracting the hydrogen percentage as minus O by 8, since we have seen that the one part of hydrogen combines with the 8 parts of the oxygen. One part of hydrogen combines with the 8 parts of oxygen. If oxygen is present in the fuel, that is present in combined state with the hydrogen in the form of water. So that hydrogen is not available for the combustion. So we have to subtract that value. First we have to minus that value from the available hydrogen for the combustion. So total hydrogen includes here available hydrogen for combustion and hydrogen already in combined state, present in the fuel. So we have to subtract the hydrogen present in the combined state in fuel from the total value. So here the available hydrogen is equal to total hydrogen minus hydrogen present in combined state with oxygen. So we are writing H minus O by 8, since one part of hydrogen is in combined state with the 8 parts of oxygen. Now, so let us do a small exercise. After HCV calculation, we know the LCV definition. So LCV is equal to HCV minus latent heat of steam, and we can write HCV minus 0.09 H into 587 kilocalories per kg, as H is the percentage of hydrogen present in that fuel. And we know that one part of hydrogen by mass gives 9 parts of water. So one part of hydrogen produces 9 parts of water by mass. So we have to subtract that value as a latent heat of steam. Next, we do one exercise, one numerical problem using this Dulong's formula. So this is a question: calculate the gross and net calorific value of a coal sample having the following composition: carbon 80%, hydrogen 7%, oxygen 3%, sulfur 3.5%, nitrogen 2.1%, and ash is equal to 4%. So here we know carbon is there in the formula, hydrogen is there in the formula, oxygen is there in the formula, sulfur is there, but nitrogen and ash are not mentioned in the formula. And they are the non-combustible substances. Nitrogen is non-combustible, ash is non-combustible, they don't contribute any calorific value. So we need not to calculate calorific value for them. And not only that, sometimes in the question, they may not give oxygen percentage. Then it is assumed to be zero. If any constituent is not mentioned in the question, means that constituent is absent. So we can substitute zero for that respective constituent. Suppose hydrogen percent is not given in the question, means substitute zero for the hydrogen, and substitute similarly oxygen value is not given, then substitute zero for the oxygen also. Now, so this is the Dulong's formula. HCV is equal to 1 by 100 into 8080 C, 34,500 H minus O by 8 plus 2,240 S kilocalories per kg. Let us substitute all the values. Carbon is 80%, so substituted 80 here. And hydrogen is given 7%, so 7 substituted here. And oxygen percent is mentioned as 3, so it is so here we substitute the 3. And sulfur is 3.5%. And finally, the calculation, we get the answer 8,828 kilocalories per kg. When you know HCV value, it is easy to calculate LCV using this formula. LCV is equal to HCV minus 0.09H into 587 kilocalories per kg. So here, LCV we have already calculated 8,828. 0.09, and H is mentioned in the question, that is 7%. So we substitute 7 and we obtain the value 8,458 kilocalories per kg. In this way, we calculate the calorific value of any fuel using Dulong's formula when you know the constituents present in the fuel. Thank you.